Imagine that you wake up one morning and, to your horror, discover that you had inadvertently committed an act of infidelity. Think about the kind of confusion and dread that might race through your head at that moment. How did that happen, and what the hell are you gonna do? How on earth are you gonna explain and amend the relationships with all parties involved? And what kind of deep-seated anxieties might have led to this moment? In 2011, Atlus's Persona studio explored this predicament with Catherine, using a peculiar blend of social simulation and Sokoban-influenced action puzzling. 8 years later, Catherine Full Body is a remaster that demonstrates how well the game's distinctive premise and exploration of adult themes still holds up, even if its new additions to the plot don't fit in seamlessly.
So, okay, I cheated on Catherine. This is bad. This is really, really bad. But I didn't make a move. She forced herself on me. Oh, f*** man. I drank way too much.
Would you mind not staring at me like that? It's kind of creepy.
Oh. Sorry.
Vincent is a 32-year-old man in a long-term relationship with his girlfriend, Catherine, and at a stagnant point in his life where he isn't exactly sure what he wants for his future. His core group of friends are in different circumstances, but they share similar dilemmas. Being in your 30s is hard. Vincent has recently found himself plagued by frequent nightmares of scrambling up a crumbling tower, and he's losing sleep and in a constant haze because of them. One morning, after a big night of drinking, he wakes up next to someone who is absolutely not his girlfriend, and what follows is a frantic, week-long crusade to try and deal with the repercussions and decide what he wants to do with his life before Catherine can discover what's really going on. Central to Vincent's coping process is his aforementioned core group of friends. Every night after work, they all get together at their local bar, the Stray Sheep, to hang out. The conversations between characters are mostly predetermined, though the onus to spend Vincent's limited time listening to them is on you. A key component which you do have influence over, however, is your cell phone. Vincent will regularly be contacted throughout the night by his girlfriend, Catherine with a K, and his new fling, Catherine with a C. And how you choose to respond to their text messages and calls, if at all, will impact Vincent's ethical compass, which is represented as a meter with opaque binaries. Time ticks along as you perform actions in the bar and its patrons will come and go. You can skip these social sections entirely if you want, but doing so robs you of the game's most engrossing component. Vincent's journey is a deeply introspective one, and though the plot's major beats unfold in the cutscenes that bookend each day, the nuances of his character come through in his interactions with other people. Managing Vincent's connection to his phone, and in turn, how he treats the women in his life from a distance, sways how he might later react to significant plot points and revelations. And it's nice to have that safe haven, because when Vincent goes home to bed each night, the nightmares start, and that's when things get really stressful. You need to guide Vincent up a sheer, crumbling tower constructed entirely of cubes and other cuboids, sometimes while being chased by a monstrous personification of one of Vincent's objects of anxiety. The tower is rarely more than 3 cubes deep, and while its construction might sometimes form a natural staircase for Vincent to climb, you'll frequently need to create a path upward yourself by pushing and pulling the cubes around in strict grid-based arrangements. This task quickly escalates in difficulty as the sheer tower faces become higher and harder to navigate. There'll be fewer pieces to work with, while blocks with unique properties will also appear, such as being immovable or shattering after being stepped on twice. Finding that potential path takes careful consideration and forward thinking, and this can be nerve-wracking. You need to keep up your momentum, lest the stage crumble underneath your feet and you fall. And the soundtrack, which is made up of rousing renditions of an inspired selection of classical pieces, really ratchets up the urgency of your ridiculous predicament to a high degree. But when you have a sequence of moves in mind, successfully put them into practice, and start flying up the tower without pause, that sense of mastery and accomplishment is incredibly exciting. This remaster also includes a number of additional difficulty options and assists, however, if reaching those moments of elation are too few and far between. These include, among other things, a safety difficulty level, which eliminates failure, and an auto-climb option that can be disabled on a whim. Full Body also includes a handful of additional modes, which dramatically increase the amount of available stages. The story mode has a remix variant, which feature new block types and stage layouts, and the in-game arcade cabinet boasts a buffet of new stages in the same vein too. Babble mode makes a return with challenging randomized stages for one or two players, and there's also a head-to-head competitive mode with local and online options. There's a lot here, but the biggest addition to Catherine Full Body is the inclusion of another potential love interest for Vincent, named Rin.
How about a name?
Rin.
Rin? That's a nice name.
Who is that, though?
While Catherine with a K is sensible and Catherine with a C is uninhibited, Rin acts as a sheepish but wholehearted personality for Vincent to fawn over. On a superficial level, story moments involving Rin will often play following whatever cinematics were part of the original game, and with that comes some pacing issues. These scenes have a strong, stylish direction, featuring more interesting edits and creative shot compositions than existing ones, but they make the rhythm of cycling between social simulation, nightmare puzzles, and stretches of cinematics feel a little unbalanced. More significantly though, the integration of Rin completely dismantles the game's enigmatic sense of mystery. Now, if you've played the original version of Catherine through to one of its many different endings, then you'll have at least some idea of how Vincent's real-world difficulties and his nightmarish tribulations are related. But in the original, it was previously hard to get any tangible sense of how things might fit together until the game's penultimate chapter. Conversely, as soon as Rin appears on screen in full body, it's immediately clear that something is amiss, and this feeling of peculiarity is ever present whenever Rin is involved in a scene. Even though Rin's arc is an enticing new mystery in itself, and it does feel additive to someone who already knows everything about the original Catherine's narrative, it's still a bit of a shame. As soon as Full Body starts, Rin acts as this big, flashy distraction from the largely grounded and plausible story that Catherine revels in during its real-world sequences for most of its running time. Pursuing Rin feels far more blatant, too. A series of questions are flagged up front as opportunities to break the morality meter and set off on a whole new path. Once you do that, things go to some fascinating places. But the broad feeling of the new story branch is that it feels, well, a little too broad. Rin's enthusiastic earnestness rubs off on the direction of the new content a little too much. And even though the scenarios posited are genuinely interesting to see unfold, it lacks some more grounded subtlety that invites a similar level of contemplation to the existing branches for Catherine with a K and Catherine with a C. What's more dismaying is that the ultimate conclusion to Rin's story branch actually feels like it kind of undermines the otherwise positive themes the new chapters work so intensely to convey, seeming to suggest that the kind of love that Rin and Vincent can potentially share is fantastical in nature. But Rin's presence still brings an intriguing new edge to Vincent's crisis, and Full Body still tells a fascinating personal tale. The nightmarish block puzzles are still weirdly intense and satisfying to surmount, and the stray sheep is still a wonderful bar to spend your nights in. Full Body does a great job in refining and refreshing the Persona Studio's fascinating foray into the social lives of adults, and Catherine continues to stand out as a game that feels both incredibly bizarre and authentically intimate.
She's totally into me, man.
No.
Ah, come on. I can dream, can't he?
You adored her so much back then. Shame how people change. On the other hand, maybe you can change again now. Where will you go from here? This is getting exciting.